أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة.
ونستغفره ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه. أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح لهذه الأمة فكشف الله تعالى به الأمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا ضال أو شقي. فاللهم اجزه عنا خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن رسالته. اللهم واسقنا من حوضه الشريف شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا يا رب العالمين. ثم ما بعد، إخوة الإيمان والإسلام، فبادئ ذي بدء أوصي نفسي وإياكم بتقوى الله عز وجل، خير ما يتقرب به المؤمن إلى ربه في يوم لا ينفع فيه مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. قال عز من قائل: وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب. Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. After Fajr today, we stop by some ayat of Surah An-Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 36. And subhanAllah, one of the friends, the brothers, asked me, what is the topic for the khutbah today? So I said, it might be related to this ayat. And subhanAllah, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I wanted to make a continuation of the best way to make da'wah to non-Muslims. So I chose this topic in particular, which is how to deal with your neighbors. Most of us, they have neighbors. They are non-Muslims. And the best way to make da'wah to Islam, to spread the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the word of truth, is to deal with them according to this ayah. وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْجَارِ الْجُنُوبِ وَالصَّاحِبِ بِالْجَنْبِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah stressed that whenever you are dealing with anyone around you, particularly your neighbors, no matter who is he, you have to deal with them in a friendly way. The way that shown to you by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the way that was established in the ayat, in the guidance of the Quran, through this ayat, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And we will, inshallah, we'll talk about the reward, the benefit of dealing good with your neighbors, whether they are Muslims or whether they are non-Muslims. And the punishment for the one. And subhanAllah, yani if you will, if we'll talk about this, if you will know how much the punishment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the person who keeps people away from Islam or away from coming again to the straight path through his dealing, I'm sure all of us will stop doing this. And that kind of evil treatment with people around you might cause you yourself to be away from the Jannah. First of all, we have to have a look at the life before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Pre the advance of Islam, before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was first sent as a prophet, Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, the Prophet's cousin, was forced to migrate from Mecca to Ethiopia, to Abyssinia. And they were received by Najashi, Nagus, who was, as the Prophet ﷺ described him, he was a very fair, just Christian ruler. And Najashi asked Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, describe me the life there in Mecca. Describe me to me the essence of the message that you have or you enforce it to flee away with it. Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu abbreviated this life in three sentences. The first he said, Inna kunna ma'ashara jahiliyatin wa shar, wa naqta'u al-arhama wa nusi'u al-juwar. Ja'far ibn Abi Talib described the life that people in Mecca lived there. The essence of the life based on everything evil, save few sides or ways. First, he described his family or his people that they were people of ignorance and they have evil nature. And they used to boycott, they cut the relations between each other. And they used to do harm, cause harmful action or acts to their neighbors. So, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he received the message of Islam, he told people that the message of Islam is not confined only to the masjid, is not confined to the reformation of the acts of worship. The guidance of Islam has to be shared with others. Since you are a Muslim, you have to share the guidance of this message with other people. Do not think that or do not believe that since you are a Muslim, you are the only one who has to practice Islam. But you have to do your best to share this, you know, guidance with other people around you. And you will see the effect, the impact upon people around you, particularly in your work, particularly in your neighbors. You will see how they will love Islam. And some of them, they might come Islam through this. When you see al-jawar and cause harmful acts, cause harms to all our neighbors. The life at that time, before the Prophet ﷺ, was filled with war, was full of war, particularly between the tribes and even between the members of the same tribe itself. A person couldn't leave his house because he has to watch his neighbor. He might attack his house. And also he is waiting for the chance to attack his neighbor. But when the Prophet ﷺ was sent as a prophet, when the message of Islam came, it changed the whole life. The Prophet ﷺ elevated the value of husn al-jawar, doing good. Or dealing in a good way, a friendly way, with your neighbors. And the Prophet ﷺ granted the neighbor the rights that helped him to establish with his brothers a safe community based on mutual love and cooperation. This is the Prophet ﷺ, and this is the essence of the message of Islam. The message of Islam is not confined to the acts of worship. Doing that, the prayer, the fasting, the hajj, and that's it. Still you have to go out, outside the mosque. You have to carry the spirit that you got from the prayer outside the mosque. Stretch this, you know, spirit to other people. Share with them the principle, the good features of Islam with the other people around you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the first one practiced, adopted this guidance revealed to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was the first one because he wanted sallallahu alaihi wasallam to strike the model example in dealing with his neighbors sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We told you about the story of that Jewish young man who served the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and when the Prophet heard about his illness, he went and visited him and asked him and told him, come to Islam. The guy, the little young man, looked at his dad, his father, and his father told him, obey Abu al-Qasim, Ati' Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when the young man came to Islam, he then died. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alhamdulillah, alladhi waqahu min al-nar, waqahu anqadani, anqadahu min al-nar bi, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Praise be to Allah, who saved him because of me from hellfire. This is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we as Muslims, we have to follow the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of us, with no exception, are representative of Islam. So which is the best way to deal with your neighbors? We will talk about this inshallah. Listen to the Quran. Listen to this ayah. It underlines the best way to deal with your neighbors. وَعَبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى, the neighbor who is from your kinship or who is from your family. وَالْجَارِ الْجُنُوبِ, the companion by your side. وَالصَّاحِبِ بِالْجَنْبِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ, the way traveler, the traveler that you might sit or, you know, accompany him in your travel. And subhanallah, if you hear or if you read the last two descriptions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us against two bad characters that they shouldn't be in the mu'min. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ مَنْ كَانَ مُخْتَانًا فَقُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like the person who is proud and he is boastful. Because when you deal with other people around you, do not think that you are preferred to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you are a mu'min or because you are a Muslim. You have to feel the responsibility towards them. Imam Ghazali rahimahullah said a very good word about this when he said rahimahullah, إِنَّ النَّاسَ أَوْ مَنْتَشَرَ الْكُفْرُ إِلَّا بِسَبَبِ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ لِأَنَّهُمْ بَغَضُوا اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ إِلَىٰ خَلْقِهِ. The cause of spreading or the evil or the kufr being spread in the whole earth is due to the bad treatment that Muslims or the believers deal with other people, particularly the disbelievers. When you deal with them, deal with them according to the teachings of Islam, not to the teaching, not the traditions that you are accompanied, that you carried with you from your own country. Deal with them the best way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed you in the Quran and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam practiced towards other people around him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the Meccan and the Medina communities sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in the Medina, there were Jews. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to deal with them friendly. Most of them, they came to Islam through this way, not through making da'wah, through the practice. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he met or had a meeting with Prophet Jibreel alayhi salam, as Abdullah ibn Umar reported that, before leaving, Jibreel alayhi salam used to advise, used to recommend the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to recommend the Prophet to take care of his neighbor. to look after him, to care about him. Till the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam thought that Allah will make his neighbor part of his family. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما زال جبريل يوصيني بالجاري حتى ظننت أنه سيورثه. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, however, he dealt very good with his neighbors. Yet he teaches you, he directs your attention to the best way to deal with your neighbors. Also, look at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when he said, as Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As reported, that خير الأصحاب خيرهم لصاحبه عند الله عز وجل وخير الجيران عند الله عز وجل خيرهم لجاره. The best of friends in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best for his friends. The one who recommends, the one who urges his friends to mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do good. And the best kind of neighbors in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who does good deeds to people around him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, يا أبا ذر إذا طبخت مرقا فأكثر ماء وتعاهد جيرانك. أبا ذر, if you cook some food, any kind of food, make it greet and take some shares to your neighbors and see how this act, how people will react to you when you invite them to your house, when you invite them to your house for any kind of meat. This gives them the feeling that you care about them. You don't have any intention to harm or cause any harm to them. This gives them the feeling that if they are good, if they are happy, you are feeling happy because of this. If they are feeling sad, you are feeling sad because of them. And see how people will come to Islam through this way. In your class, they also, all people around you in the class, they are your neighbors. Because you stay with them a long time, more than the time you stay at your home. So consider them, regard them as your neighbors, and deal with them this way. Try to invite someone outside to an ameen, or even invite them to the masjid at the bootleg dinner, to let them know how great Islam is. And you will see how people will think about you as a Muslim, and about your religion, Islam. Aisha radiallahu anha, the Prophet's wife, asked him, يا رسول الله, إن لي جيران, فأيهما أتعاهد بالهدية, أو فأيهما أهدي إلي. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, إلى أقربهما من كبابة, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Aisha radiallahu anha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'd like to offer a present. Which one of my neighbors should I, you know, prefer first or give first? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, the one closest to your door, the one closest to you, to your heart. And if you know that they are sick, go and visit them. Go and tell them that we are Muslims and we care about all people regardless of their religion, regardless of their dogmas. And you will see the reaction of those people towards you, towards your deen. We said in a previous khutbah that the best thing to make da'wah through is to practice Islam first. It's better to practice Islam in front of others better than giving them good words. Practice before doing any action. And the Prophet ﷺ, as we said, he struck the very fine example in this way. Also, if you think about the punishment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for that person who betrays, who does bad actions to his neighbors, regardless, as I have said, of the religions or religious views. The Prophet ﷺ, as in Miqdad ibn Aswad narrated, he was sitting and talking, advising his companions, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he asked them, ما تقولون في الزنا؟ قالوا, الزنا حرام حرمه الله ورسوله فهو حرام إلى يوم القيامة. فقال رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم: لأن يزني الرجل بعشر نسوة أيسر عند الله من أن يزني بحليلة جاره. ثم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما تقولون في السرقة؟ قالوا: حرام، حرمه الله ورسوله، فهو حرام إلى يوم القيامة. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم: لأن يسرق الرجل من عشرة أبيات أيسر عند الله من أن يسرق من بيت جاره. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, while advising his companions, he asked them, what do you think about committing adultery? They said, it's a haram. It's forbidden by Allah and his Prophet. So it's a haram till the day of judgment. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told them, a person who commits adultery, and this we have to note this, this does not mean that committing adultery is halal or something allowable. It is haram. But the more heinous in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to commit adultery with one's neighbor's wife. And also, commit, you know, stealing from the houses of people. It is haram. But it's more haram when it comes to stealing from the house of your neighbor. Even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam related the safety of your iman, the completion of your iman, with being your neighbor being saved for your bad actions. لا يدخل الجنة من لا يأمن جاره بوائقه. No one will enter Jannah if his neighbor is not saved from his, you know, his acts, bad acts or evil acts. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم that لا يؤمن والله لا يؤمن والله لا يؤمن. The Sahaba asked him, who? He will not have a complete iman. The Sahaba asked him, who is that person, O Messenger of Allah? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من لا يأمن جاره بوائقه. The one whose neighbor is not saved from his bad actions. So imagine that. When your neighbor is have a wedding party and you went and you shared him his happy times. But according to the, you know, the teaching of Islam, how, imagine how he will react to your deen. And if he feels that, if he passes through bad times or sad times, show him that our Islam teaches you to care about him. And particularly when it comes to private matters, when you know anything about his private life, do not prevail it. Because this is more harmful. This is aziyah and khiyana. This is a bad action. And also at the same time, it is considered in Islam as betrayal of the amana. Because that person, when he leaves, he is sure that, particularly when he knows that you are a Muslim, you will care about his family. You will guard, you will protect his family in his, you know, absence. So let people around you know that you are a Muslim through your action, not through your words. أقول قولي هذا وصف الله العلي العظيم لي ولكم. صف الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا يحقرن أحدكم من المعروف شيئا ولو أن يلقى أخاه بوجه طلق. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam draw our attention to the fact that smile that you might think it is trifle thing might cause people to love Islam and to come Islam. While you are going out to your work, you might meet your neighbor. Smile at his face. Show him that you like to meet him. Do not be, you know, do not make him feel that you dislike to meet him. Even this action will bring you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and might even cause you to be a member of the Jannah, a dweller of the Jannah. And listen, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrated that, قال رجل يا رسول الله إن فلانة يذكر من صلاتها وصيامها وصدقتها غير أنها تؤذي جيرانها. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: هي في النار. ثم قال الرجل يا رسول الله إن امرأة أو إن فلانة يذكر من قلة صيامها وصدقتها غير أن من قلة صيامها وصلاتها غير أنها تتصدق بالأواثر من الأقط. قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم هي في الجنة. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه narrated that a man said, O messenger of Allah, people talked about a woman, so and so woman, how she worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how she performs siyam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how she pays in a charity in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet she harms, she causes harmful actions to her neighbors. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she is in the hellfire. وَالْعَيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. Then the man said, O messenger of Allah, people talked about another lady. She, you know, she does not worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that much. Yet she pays in a charity anything left with her. Very few. She pays very few in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet she deals good with her neighbors. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, هي في الجنة. She will be in the Jannah. So the act that you will do based on your teachings, the teachings that you derive from your deen. Your deen orders you to deal good with all people around you. And you have to show this to people in your house, in your class, even while you are traveling. And make sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at you. And He might consider you as an element of driving people away from the deen. So why? We are, alhamdulillah, we are here for a message. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose you to be here for a cause, which is to deliver da'wah. To deliver da'wah to non-Muslims. And imagine that as Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Ali ibn Abi Talib, لِأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ أَنْ يَكُونَ لَكَ حُمُرٌ نِعْمٌ. The best for you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to cause you to be a means of guidance for a person with whom you have a relation. Better than you having that whole world. And we have to do something to the deen. We have to tell people that, particularly nowadays, this is not the deen that the mass media tells you about. This is the deen that we have to communicate to other people. And you will see how effectively this way brings people to the deen. اللهم بلغت اللهم أشهد اللهم عافنا وعافنا اللهم عافنا وعافنا اللهم عافنا وعافنا وشر خلقك سلمنا اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين ومستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم كن لهم ولا تكن عليهم اللهم زلزل الأرض من تحت أقدام أعدائهم اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت أعلم به منا عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وأنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وقوموا إلى صلاتكم الحمد لله.